Hi sewing friends, welcome to my sewing room. My name is Beth and today we're making one of the easiest quilts there is to make. These are 5-inch blocks. I call it an I Spy quilt, but of course you could use some pretty flowers. You could use all stripes, all plaids, all blues, all pinks, and the list goes on. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take my squares and I will put them, sew them right next to one another. And I'll make rows of 8 and I'll make 9 rows. So 8 squares across. And once I have 9 of these long strips of squares, I will put the strips together. Here are my 3 layers. Now I have my quilt top, my batting, and my backing. And I'll be taking a 505 spray and spraying it right on the batting just a little bit and smoothing the quilt top really well right on top of the batting. And my batting is a couple inches bigger than my quilt top. And then of course the backing, the same thing. It's bigger, so I will have to trim it off when I'm done quilting. I will use the 505 spray on the front and then I'll turn it over and do the same thing on the back. One of the easiest ways to quilt a quilt, I think, is to just do straight lines. And when you have squares like this, there's no marking involved. I'll just be going diagonally through the quilt and I'll start in the middle. And I'm not using a walking foot. Some machines may need you to use a walking foot. My machine seems to work all right just using the regular foot. I make the stitch just a little bit bigger and I'm able to stitch through the quilt with no problem. After going all the way through all the squares one direction, I turned my quilt and I ended up making X's with my quilting lines through all of the squares in this little quilt. I took my quilt to the table and a cutting mat and I trimmed off the batting and the backing just following the quilt, the edge of the quilt there. Now I'll have those leftover lavender strips to put in my scrap basket for the next quilt. For this little quilt, I needed 4 strips of binding, 2.5 inches, the width of fabric, and I put them right sides together, sort of at, a right angle, and then I sew diagonally through the 2 pieces, and I just keep going along until all of the strips are sewn together, and after I sew them all together, I will trim off the little triangle ends, and I will press that long strip of binding in half. For your kids' quilts that I hope will be used again and again, I will add the binding to the back of the quilt and then roll it over to the front with the top stitch. So when I got the binding almost on, I left 10 to 12 inch gap there. I fold one of the ends over and cut it off, and then right next to where I cut off the left side, I folded the right side, and I want to measure 2.5 inches, and I use that leftover piece of binding to give me just the size that I need. So when I sew these two ends together, it should fit exactly. So I will put my ends together, right sides together, just like I did before the binding was on the quilt, sort of at a right angle like this. I needed to bunch up the quilt so that I could sew, and then I will sew corner to corner that same diagonal line. I'll pin, and if you're not sure you can eyeball this, just draw yourself a line with pencil and sew that little seam. I trimmed off that leftover triangle there, those two triangles hanging off, and then my binding should fit just right on this quilt. So I'll pin, I'll finish that seam on the back side of the quilt, then I'll roll it over and stitch all the way around the quilt. So this is probably one of the easiest quilts to make. I hope you will be encouraged to make one to give away or to use yourself. Thank you for sewing with me today, and I'll see you next time.